While looking for work as an underground newspaper cartoonist, Kevin Eastman was introduced to fellow cartoonist Peter Laird after a mutual acquaintance thought they shared an interest in the same kind of weird shit. In 1983, Laird's living room was renamed Mirage Studios, and there the newly formed team began work on their first long-form comic, The Fugitoid. But as the late nights mounted, a delirious Eastman scribble turned into a friendly game of cartoon improv as they passed drawings back and forth. Still amused and exhilarated the next morning, the pair decided to tell the story of their Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. As inspiration for that story, they turned to cartoonist Frank Miller, thinly homaging, if not full-blown satirizing, the writer-artist's work on Daredevil. In Daredevil, Matt Murdock rescues an elderly pedestrian from an out-of-control truck, but is blinded and ultimately mutated by the truck's radioactive cargo. In Turtles lore, that radioactive canister bounces off the boy's head and smashes into a bowl of baby turtles, who fall into an open manhole. There, a vengeance-seeking rat named Splinter finds the turtles in a pool of radioactive ooze, and goes on to become their father figure and sensei in an homage to Daredevil's stick. Soon thereafter, the turtles took on the evil ninja clan of the Foot, a reference to Daredevil's foe, the Hand. Borrowing $1,300 from Eastman's uncle, they printed 3,000 copies. The series took off almost immediately and became a global bonanza, yielding countless iterations of the Turtles that have lasted nearly 40 years.